Race fans, one of the great new experiences we have out here at NHRA Races is right here in the Toyota Racing display. Now, you're looking at this and you're thinking to yourself, what's so special about this? It looks like a regular nitro motor you'd see in one of our Top Fuel or Funny cars. But spin around to the other side and you start to see where the magic is as Todd Smith, the co-crew chiefs on JR Todd's Gator Nationals winning car, is about to tell us. This is a Cutaway nitro engine that the folks at Kalitta Motorsports spent the winter putting together on behalf of Toyota to come out here and actually give our fans, Todd, really for the first time, an inside look at what one of these motors that makes 12,000 horsepower looks like. How much went into building this first off?
Well, quite a bit, actually. You know, the team in the machine shop, Scott Finnis and his guys, worked on it all winter, you know, and it was a cool project because, like you said, it's a Cutaway. It kind of gives people a different perspective of how one of these engine works.
This is literally a complete motor, basically, from front of the supercharger all the way back to the clutch. So I'm going to actually have Todd walk us through basically every part that's working on one of these motors and allows these cars to go down the track. So why don't we start at the front here, Todd, because this is the first time that I think I've ever seen a Cutaway like that.
Yeah, that's an interesting Cutaway section of our regular fuel pumps for one of these things. There's a couple of different manufacturers, but typically they all work the same. They're a gear pump. This is a gear in here. There's two sections in this particular pump, and the size of the output of the pump is dictated by the size of this gear. And typically in this range, you're going to see this flow about 115 gallons per minute.
115 gallons per minute. We work our way up, and you start to see the front of the snout, as we talk about, because it comes off sometimes on a supercharger, and walk fans through this entire upper section of the motor.
So, yeah, the top end of the motor here, where we get a lot of our horsepower in these things, is obviously from the supercharger. Nice Cutaway here. It shows the impellers, the rotors inside of the blower here. You know, that's all being driven from the front with a belt. We got a pulley on the bottom, the hook to the crankshaft that spins this thing at whatever speed we want to change that. It displaces the air that comes in through the injector, comes out of the blower, into the intake manifold, and into the cylinder heads, along with the fuel and the ignition from the spark. That's where we get our 12,000.
And I think it's interesting to point out, we had some fans looking at it here, but even from the top, I mean, we're feeding fuel into this car anywhere we can find it.
Yeah, absolutely. Anywhere we can get it. You know, we have two fuel nozzles in each cylinder in the cylinder heads. We have one for each cylinder in the intake manifold and one for each cylinder up here in the injector. So there's a lot of areas where we can get fuel into this thing because we need to make up for the amount of air we're going in there too.
Then we get down into the middle part and the bottom end of the engine over here, which if fans are able to get down, they can actually see, and we can as well. And this is where, when we talk about nitro motors coming apart, catastrophe is where it happened.
Absolutely. This is what we refer to as our rotating assembly. The bullet, you know, the strength of this thing. Obviously, inside of here, we have a forged steel crankshaft inside of the engine, and then we have aluminum pistons, aluminum connecting rods, and then inside of each of our main housing is bearings, regular engine bearings in there. But this is where we get all of our power right here. This is what's transmitting the power to the clutch and ultimately to the driveline.
And then in the back of this car, and you just brought up the clutch, but this actually has a working, and these are, I want to point out, new parts that are essentially working parts. If this car would have been completed and not cut, you could put this into a race car and spin it over right now. And here is the clutch assembly in the back. This is something that I don't think fans, they see the clutch parts, right? We give away discs and floaters that have been used up as race teams out here. But not often do fans get to see an entire clutch pack attached to a motor. So talk to us about how this piece actually works and why it's so important.
So this is obviously important because of the amount of horsepower we can make. So this is our ability to manage this horsepower and get it directed to the rear end. So typically here we have a very heavy, strong flywheel that bolts right to the crankshaft. And then in individual clutch discs, in this case we have 6 clutch discs and 5 floater plates. On top of this is what we call our pressure plate or our donut. And here is 18 centrifugal levers that we are used to adjust that. So by nature, this is a centrifugal clutch. So the higher the engine RPM, the harder these fingers apply and they smash these discs and floaters together, which makes friction, which makes the drive output work.
When we talk about glorified go-kart engines,
pretty much, yeah. Yeah, like this is, you know, the slipper clutch has been around for decades and decades, but nitro guys have managed to dial this thing in pretty well over the years. And it, there's a lot of moving parts here. It's really intricate, and it takes a lot of good people to keep up with just this department.
thank you so much for walking us through this. Just one of the great things you can see when we come out here to NHRA National Events right here in the Toyota Racing Display. If you've ever wanted to see a fuel motor completely built up close, what it looks like and how it works, you now have that opportunity.